Well, I'm replacing these Sukup Deadheads. They're bulky, they're heavy, they're really hard to slide up and down the pipe, and they got huck bolts that like to snag you and cut you if they can. I'm replacing them with these Max Steel pipe deadheads. They're lighter and easier to slide up and down, and you can throw bucket extensions on the end if you need, instead of having to weld an angle ring onto a spout to get it longer. And then the Sukup deadheads also, they don't cut the hole big enough where it slides over the pipe, and that's one thing that makes them hard to wrestle up and down. But on top of it, they're heavy and awkward, and you get up there and sometimes it's just tough to get in the right position. You need to pull them, and sometimes even if you can get in the right position, it's just still too hard to get them up there because they catch so much. I've reamed them out before and they slide easier, but even then they're still a little tough to deal with. I just bought a Hero 10 GoPro. Takes really nice video that I'm recording this with. Pretty impressed with the quality of video it can take. It was about 7 years ago I got a Hero 4 GoPro for my wife, and she never used it. About 3 years after that, she gave it back to me for my birthday. And I never used it until just this video, and I'm not impressed with it at all. It was a brand new, it was the newest model they had when I got it for her. But they just didn't have the quality they have now. So I won't be using the Hero 4 in any of my future videos. It's just too shaky and the sound quality's too rough. Give it to my children, let them play around with it and see if they can have some fun. I had it mounted in my head. The Hero 10 is about the same quality, if not better, when it's sped up 5 times the speed. So yeah, most likely won't be using it in any more of my videos. Those deadheads just don't like to move. You can see the huck bolts that are sticking out there. They're kind of sharp. They like to snag you if they can. just a nasty, really heavy deadhead. So I put this bolt here in the end of the pipe so that if the farmer's up there trying to pull the deadhead up into place, that it can't come off the end of the pipe and he go over the end, over the bin with the deadhead. Or another thing that's happened is people have forgotten to tighten the clamp down on the deadhead, and when they turn the air system on, it'll blow the deadhead off the other side of the grain bin. It's a hazard for people on the other side and equipment. So I drill a hole in the end of the pipe there and put a bolt there so it's a stop for it to hit against when they're up there working. It's almost unbelievable how easy these things are to slide up and down. You just grab them with the hand and they just slide up and down with ease, just with the breeze. And you can actually get your impact on the bolt that next to the deadhead on these. It just makes a whole lot more sense all the way around as far as I can tell. there, those two deadheads will be a whole lot easier and safer for the farmer to deal with from now on. And back to the Hero 4 again.
better. Two down. Well, that's all the ones I have to replace legs out. Now I gotta add one of those big old ugly ones back up to the top of that far bin over there. It has a red spout on it. It's got a hole in it. I grill the tape just for the season to get it by.
Battery died on my ear before, fortunately. I mounted a ear tin to my head, and it's a whole lot more stable, clearer video. It takes out a lot of the vibration. It's really nice.
Looks like it wore some, a little bit of stuff off there, but it held up pretty well. I'm not thick enough. Oh, good luck getting that Sukup Deadhead back on this out around the pipe. Not a big clunker. And this one's a bigger clunker. If I've ever said I hate these deadheads, but seems like it's been maybe 150 times. And I still hate them. Okay, line that up pretty straight there. hand tighten the nasty thing on. Smash that one down. Bolt. Wasn't me. So there's 1 foot. So if I went like 11 inches on the spout there, there are 10 inches. I'm gonna build a 10 inch spout extension and they can still get their roof open.
course it had to go start raining just to make the benders a little bit more slippery and challenging just for the fun of it.
Well, done with that job.